Welcome students to our new lecture on quantum chemistry. Today we will be discussing about de Broglie's hypothesis. In our previous lectures we had seen it reasons for failure of classical mechanics and how quantum mechanics could explain certain experiments like Compton effect, photoelectric effect or black body radiation experiments were being explained very nicely by quantum mechanics, but where classical mechanics failed to explain the observations that were being done under these experiments. Today we will see about how this quantum mechanics developed into a different science where it could be applied to microscopic particles. After the experiment of Compton, what Compton had suggested, or through the experiment of Compton, we had seen that the waves or the light or electromagnetic radiation has both the wave nature as well as it has a matter nature or material nature, was being explained by the Compton experiment. In the Compton scattering, it was done that the radiation was incident over an electron. It strikes with electron and changes its direction, and the electron is ejected out in a different direction. What was basically the wavelength of this ejected wavelength of this deflected wave was different from the wavelength of the incident radiation. This could happen only when there is a collision is happening between two particles. Now in that cases, both the particles are considered as a matter, and so from this experiment of Compton we could explain that waves or light is also behaving like a matter. So one quantum or one photon that suggested by Einstein is nothing but a matter is there with a very small minuscule mass, but it is behaving like a matter in the experiment of Compton scattering. Similarly, based on this, de Broglie suggested in 1924 proposed that the wave characteristics of matter are also present. Unlike what we have waves associated with wave characteristics as well as matter characteristics, similarly matter is also associated with material properties as well as the wave properties, like it should have a wavelength, frequency and many other properties that were associated with waves only. So de Broglie suggested that the wave characteristics of matter. Accordingly, he argued that unlike radiations, matter also possesses a wave particle dual nature. As the Compton effect or Compton scattering has proved the dual particle nature, wave particle dual nature of waves, similarly, de Broglie suggested that matter is also possessing wave particle dual nature, unlike what the photons or the waves are having. Based on this experiment, based on this hypothesis, de Broglie had suggested that matter is not only moving in one direction with the velocity v, but it also has a wavelength associated with it. This wavelength may be very smaller than what we have it for the waves, but still it possesses a certain waves present in this case. So from this, what he had argued, that de Broglie proposed the wave characteristics of matter. And accordingly, what he had suggested that he gave two equations, he combined it from Planck's equation. We have E is equal to h nu, where energy of associated with the wave is given as E is equal to h nu, where nu is the frequency of the radiation, h is Planck's constant, and E is the energy associated with the wave. Let this be our equation one. And similarly, from Einstein's equation, what we can have is, from Einstein's equation, we have E is equal to mc square, which relates with the energy with the matter or material or mass. So E is equal to mc square. When we combine these two, both of them are having LHS as same, so we can have equally RHS, we have h nu is equal to mc square, nu can be written as it is a frequency, it can be written as c upon lambda. So if we replace it here, hc upon lambda equals mc square, one of the c gets cancelled, we have h upon lambda equals mass into velocity. If we take this velocity of matter, material particle moving it, so we can write it as h upon lambda is equal to m into v. Therefore, we can have lambda is equal to h upon m into v. Product mass into velocity, we can have it always as mass into velocity as momentum of the particle, which can be replaced by p. So we can have here lambda is equal to h upon p. This equation, we call it as de Broglie's equation. This equation lambda is equal to h upon p is a de Broglie's equation which relates with the wavelength of a particle with the momentum of it. So momentum being a material or a particle nature, wavelength being a wave nature, or it's a wave property, momentum is a particle property. So it is equating the particle property with a wave property. De Broglie proposed that a material particle will have a matter wave associated with it, just as light quantum has light wave. Thus, for a particle of mass m moving with a velocity v, the wavelength lambda is given as lambda equals h upon p, which is equal to h upon m into v, where m is mass of the particle and v is the velocity associated with the particle. This is referred to as de Broglie's wavelength of a moving particle. So this was first time when the particles were also being associated with wave natures. As it is having, de Broglie has suggested about the matter waves. So let us see what are the differences between the electromagnetic waves and the matter waves. Electromagnetic waves have electric and magnetic fields associated with them, like what we had seen it. If this is our direction of propagation of the electromagnetic wave, then this will be the electrical field and this can be the magnetic field associated with the wave. So it can both are perpendicular to each other and also perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So electromagnetic waves will be associated with electric as well as magnetic fields are associated with them. Matter waves do not have such electric or magnetic fields associated with them. So that is the basic difference between matter waves and electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves can easily pass through vacuum, but matter waves cannot pass through vacuum. Similarly, electromagnetic waves have fixed velocities. Here, if the velocity is approximately 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second, while matter waves have velocities less than this velocity of electromagnetic waves, and it also depends on the situation. It will change with the situation. Wavelengths of electromagnetic radiation can be measured easily because they are in the measurable regions. Our instruments are easily used to measure the wavelengths of the electromagnetic waves, while wavelengths associated with matter waves are very small, and so it cannot be measured using the existing instruments. So wavelengths cannot be measured easily except for electrons. Electrons ke hum wavelengths easily measure kar sakte hain because inke jo wavelengths hote hain wo angstrom ke region mein aate hain. Angstrom to picometers ke region mein aate hain, and so we can easily measure the wavelengths associated with electrons because their mass is very small. Lekin jaise mass badhta hai waise uska wavelength kam hote jata hai, and so it is very difficult to measure the wavelengths. Similarly, for electromagnetic wave, waves are emitted from source in space, while these matter waves are associated with material particles. They are not emitted out, but they are associated with a material particle, and they do not exist without materials. If the matter is lost, then the wave is also lost from it. Electromagnetic waves, the energies of these waves are quantized, like what we have seen it in the Planck's theory of quantization. Matter waves are not quantized, they are in continuous energies. So these are the basic differences between electromagnetic waves and matter waves. Let us consider an electron which is accelerated through a potential difference of V volt. If the electron of mass m and charge E is accelerated through a potential difference of V volt, then the kinetic energy associated with this electron can be given as half mv square, which is the kinetic energy of a particle, can be equal to the charge on the particle into the potential difference through which it has been accelerated. So half mv square can be equal to EV. If we put this half on the other side, we will get mv square equals 2E into V. Now, if you multiply both sides by mass, then we get m square V square equals 2MEE into V. If we take root of both sides, we will get m into V equals under root 2MEV. So this we know that it is a momentum. So it will be momentum P is equal to under root 2MEE into V. So we can find out the wavelengths associated with the electron which is accelerated through a potential difference of V volt possessing mass m and charge E. Now this, in the de Broglie's equation, we have H is we have lambda is equal to H upon P. If we replace this P by this under root 2 m into E into V, we will get lambda is equal to H upon under root 2ME into V, where V is the potential difference through which the electron has been accelerated, which is possessing a charge of E and mass m. Any particle which is having charge E and mass m, if it is accelerated through a potential difference V, its wavelength can be calculated using this particular formula. Lambda is equal to H upon under root 2ME into V. So using this equation, we can easily find out the matter wavelength associated with the particle. Let us have some problems. Calculate the wavelength associated with proton moving with velocity of 10 to the power of 5 meters per second given H value and the mass of the proton. Now when we have mass of the proton is given, velocity is also given to you. H is also given. It is a straightforward problem and to calculate wavelength from de Broglie's equation. Lambda is equal to H upon m into V, where m is mass of the proton, V is 10 to the power of 5 meters per second. H is given here, 6.626 into 10 raised to minus 34 joule second. So substituting values, we will get the wavelength of the proton. Second problem is, what voltage must be applied to an electron microscope to produce electrons of wavelength 0.4 angstroms? What is being given or what is being asked over here is that we have been asked the voltage or the potential difference through which the electrons must be accelerated so that the wavelength associated with electrons is 0.4 angstrom. We have the equation just now, we had seen it. Lambda is equal to H upon under root 2m E into V, where V, we have to find it out. We have been provided with electrons. So mass of electron, we can take it as ME is equal to 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kilograms. So mass of the electrons is given. We have E charge. Charge on the electron is 1.602 into 10 raised to minus 19 Coulomb. So that will be the charge on the electron. We have a wavelength 0.4 angstrom, that is 0.4 into 10 raised to minus 10 meters. So everything is given, just we need to calculate the V value. V value can be easily calculated from here. And the third problem is, a charged particle accelerated by 200 volt has a de Broglie wavelength of 0.2 angstroms. Find the mass of the particle. This is also a very much similar problem over here. Instead of voltage, we have been asked to find out m. Voltage has been given to you as 200 volt. We can substitute that in the equation. Lambda equals H upon under root 2m E into V. So V is 200 volts. E is 1.602 into 10 raised to minus 19 charged particle accelerated. So let us consider this having one charge. So let that be equal to one charge. So E will be 1.602 into 10 raised to minus 19. We have been given wavelength as 0.2 angstrom. So lambda will be equal to 0.2 into 10 raised to minus 10 meters. And we have to calculate the value of M. M can be easily calculated using this particular equation. Fourth problem is electron beams are accelerated to potentials 40 kilovolt and 150 kilovolt. Estimate the wavelengths of the electrons in the two beams. You have been given H, mass of the electron is given, and one electron volt is also given. The charge associated with one electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 joules. Electron volt. If it is just an electron charge, then it will be a coulomb. So it is not a problem here. It was right here. C is also correct. So it is a charge associated with one electron is a coulomb. So from this, what we can have is we can calculate the accelerated potentials, estimate the wavelengths. So lambda 1, we can have it as H upon under root 2m E into V1, where V1 is equal to 40 kilovolt, that is 40,000 volts, and V2 is 150 kilovolt. That will be equal to 150,000 volts. So this is for first. Second, lambda 2 equals H upon under root 2m E into V2. All things remains constant. So just V1 and V2 we have to substitute it and to find out the two wavelengths associated with the electron beams which are accelerated through potentials 40 kilovolt and 150 kilovolts. So these are straightforward problems with the de Broglie's hypothesis. These are simple problems which can be easily done. Thank you.